Sports betting is definitely going mainstream.
Whether it's a wager between friends, Super Bowl squares, or fantasy teams, sports betting has been around since sport was invented.
It's been something that, you know, has been a part of culture and sports culture, just not legalized and just not regulated and just not in a way that benefits the state, so they get the tax returns on that.
Sports betting is legal in 33 states. 19 have come on board in the last year. And Doug Turfer of Maxim Bet believes Minnesota has a good reason to get on board.
The state is surrounded by other states that are either legal or going to soon to be legal. Just to your south, Iowa did $2 billion in sports betting last year.
According to a Morning Consult survey, 18% of adults 21 and older bet on sports at least once a month, accounting for more than $52.7 billion throughout the year.
It's always kind of been the one missing piece of the puzzle from a sports fan perspective.
That means more eyes and interest on sports. See, historically, there is a high correlation between a sporting event's viewership and the number of bets placed on that event, which is why leagues aren't shying away from gambling partnerships.
When you look at it from the different things that you can bet on now, it does make it a lot more entertaining, and that's where it does help sports and kind of helps the fan have something to look forward to till the very end.
Of course, it's not all rosy. It's estimated roughly 2% of Americans are addicted to gambling, which is one of the reasons the shift to legalization has been a slow process.
There's things to do to make sure people are betting responsibly. It's a very important topic, making sure that they're setting limits. They go into any sports betting with a game plan. There is a process to that.
And most states that have legalized gambling put a percentage of their profits to programs to counter problem gambling. So they have those measures in place.
Yeah, it sounds like this is trending this way, though, to legalize it and then also try to regulate it.
Yeah, we'll have to see. But if you know someone who needs help with gambling addiction, there are resources available. The National Problem Gambling Helpline is on your screen. You can also contact the Minnesota Alliance on Problem Gambling.
Let me check it out.